I was working for BBC Radio Merseyside at the time, and as anticipation built, I could see a mass of supporters draped in red and white and gold making their way to the game, singing and chanting.